ये मेरा रिक्वेस्ट। श्री सुरेश प्रभु समय का ध्यान रखेंगे।
सर सर नॉर्मली आई विल ऑलवेज अबाइड बाय व्हाट यू से, बट सर इन दिस हाउस इट सीम्स
यस यस
दैट सर इट सीम्स इन दिस हाउस दैट रूल्स आर एप्लीकेबल टू दोज हु फॉलो द रूल्स। So I always follow the rules. So please give me time. Like in normally we are talking about oceanography. What happens in that iceberg? What you see is only 1/3, 2/3 is below the ice. So I will let me allow to finish my speech. Sir.
You are learned member.
1/10 is below.
Sir, this bill is trying to create a new university to deal with maritime studies, which are so important for India. Sir, globally. If you look at the whole biological life, most of it, predominant of it, lies in the oceans. So studying ocean is not just doing studies related to oceans alone, but actually that is also studying the life which we see all the time on ground. So this is a very important aspect of discovering our own self when we are discovering the oceans. And therefore, this type of university, this type of centers of excellence is a welcome thing. So therefore, I would welcome such creation of universities. Sir, it is important to note that thermal temperature. So oceans also maintain the temperature of the world. If the thermal temperature goes down or goes up, it affects the whole country, whole world. And the Minister of Shipping was also Minister of Environment. Sir, the rainfall pattern is also determined by what happens in the ocean. So oceans are so important. And therefore, I welcome this, but I would like to request the minister, sir, when he is talking about creation of a university, he is talking about in the clause 4, which is the object clause of the bill, he says that emerging areas he would like to study. And what he mentions as emerging areas, oceanography, maritime history. History normally is associated with past, not with the emerging area, right? But anyway, but we are talking about emerging areas, so oceanography is something which has been known to the mankind for a long time. So oceanography is a very generic term. I would request the minister to tell us what part of oceanography you like to study as emerging areas. Because emerging areas are something which are the new frontiers of change which are going to happen. Which are those areas? Which are the areas on which you like to focus? That I would like to know. And also to elaborate on this in a more detail. Sir, one of the two areas. Sir, there is a very big challenge to humanity. Sir, in the last 100 years probably, the sea level has risen by almost 0.5 centimeter. And it is estimated if the global emissions go beyond 450 to 550 ppm, then probably the temperature will rise by 2%, as a result of which the glaciers will melt and the water will come into the ocean, and probably the sea level will rise by 2 centimeters. If that happens, most of our coastal line on east coast and west coast will be extremely susceptible. And to avoid that, we really need to do studies on what is going to be the impact of this. So are we really studying this? And therefore I would request the minister to focus on this as a broad aspect of climate change and its relationship with oceans and its relationship with sea level rise. That should be the focus area. And therefore I would request you to please do that. As I was looking at emerging areas, I don't know whether minister would like to now include in emerging areas how to deal with piracy. Is this something you like to deal? Because sir, I am really surprised, and the government should have given us a proper response, that our ship have been captured by the pirates for a long time. Our Indian ships and Indian crew are actually rotting there. Nobody knows what is going to happen. The Prime Minister, I don't know whether he has called somebody, because he is now in a new relationship with President Bush, probably should help us to get our crew out, to get our ship out. So therefore, probably in view of this, I would request whether you are dealing also with piracy as area. Sir, my point, and my friend was making a very strong plea for having more than one university. So I would really support it. What a large country like India, you are getting a bill passed only to create one university. So we have got East Coast, we have got West Coast. There are several coastal states, different problems, different locations, different issues. So therefore, why not have more than one university? And I'm not opposing it being located in Chennai. I'm just saying, why not have more universities? Chennai is part of India, it should be there. But my point is, why do you want to mention in the bill the location at Chennai, Mumbai, Kolkata or something else? You should mention instead, my request is, mention state of Tamil Nadu, state of Maharashtra, because we are already thinking of bringing out with rural development plans. Why should we be located in Chennai? Why should we not be located in Tuticorin or some other areas, which are the coastal areas? Why should we be located in Mumbai? Rather than, I will strongly say, it should be located in Sindhudurga district, not because it is my constituency, but because it is one of the most important areas of marine life known to National Institute of Oceanography. So why should it not be located there? So my request is, mention the state. Don't mention the location, and as far as possible, diversify it into inner areas, into the hinterland, rather than concentrating everything in Mumbai, Delhi, Kolkata, because, sir, these are the centers in which we already do it. So I'm coming to close, sir. Sir, 2-3 issues. I would request the minister. Sir, he's already planning 5 locations. And in fact, absorb the institutions which are already functioning and extend them and bring them into the family of this university. My request to the minister, please look at it like this. Each of these locations should be developed as center of excellence in specific areas. Don't try to just allow them, just take them in your family and say they were so far only colleges, now they have become university. Rather than that, why don't you develop each of these locations as a center of excellence in a specific area? What will happen as a result of this? You'll be able to generate more research, more thinking, more knowledge on each of these areas. And sir, my last point, and I'm winding up because I would like to abide by your direction. Sir, my request to the minister is, you have included so many areas. One of the emerging areas, if you really look at it, is training the crew that is required to man the ship. Philippines, China, these are the countries which are now earning huge amount of money by training the ship. In fact, some of the Indian flag carriers have to recruit overseas staff. So why not start an institution to train people so that they could be manning the ship? Sir, you will be very happy to know that India is now the single largest destination for receiving remittance money from all over the world. These are who are the people who are sending the money? The people who work in Kerala, who are working as workers overseas, and they send the money back. Just imagine if we actually now exploit the potential that is available in maritime frontiers to get money from the people who work on the ship, how much more money we'll earn. So my request to minister, you are doing this university only for research. Have more universities for more research, but while doing that, have one institution, one university to actually train personnel who could earn foreign exchange for India and also solid employment.
Thank you, Prabhuji.